China is building a new world of its own with mighty new infrastructure. And in China's pursuit of connectivity, they just redefined how the bridges should be built. China has just evolutionized the paradigm and now is the new trendsetter. And now China is building the mega bridges the fastest way possible. But how big can they be? Especially, how fast they are building such stuff? Let's find more. Hello, tech geeks. Welcome to the Tech World, your most trustworthy and thoroughly updated channel for all kinds of technological news, scientific discoveries, and inventions, along with a glimpse of the future world. So hurry up and subscribe now, and ring the notification bell to get all the updates. Having said that, let's dive right in. China, the world's largest country with respect to its population, is also making its name in technological developments. Since the 1980s, China has made significant advances in science and technology, which has seen tremendous development from the 1980s to the 2010s. During the period of 1980 to 190, China has initiated many projects like 863 Plan and Strategy for rejuvenating the country with respect to science, technology, construction, and education. The Chinese government has prioritized science and technology as an essential component of the nation's socio-economic development, and for reasons of national prestige, through funding, reform, and societal position. China has achieved rapid strides in a variety of fields, including publishing, patents, commercial applications, high-tech manufacturing, education, and infrastructure, and is now a global leader in some of these areas. Chinese President Xi Jinping laid out his goals for China to overtake the world as a leader in science and technology in June 2016. Speaking at the China Association for Science and Technology's National Congress, he asserted that by 2030, China must be on track to become one of the world's top innovators. According to Jinping, the country and humanity could not do anything with any innovation. Innovation should be carried out speedily to get fruitful results. In order to improve the life of people, advancements in technology are the need of the hour. Since the early 2000s, China has worked to improve its industrial and transportation capacities to better serve the requirements of the citizens who live and work there. This marked the start of a sort of bridge revolution, during which time the government started financing substantial bridge-building initiatives. They started planning their most amazing effort yet, creating a bridge that would link the cities of Shanghai and Nanjing, after several successful projects and world records for outstanding constructions. Building the longest bridge in the world required the participation of numerous engineers, architects, and designers from various nations. The building plans were completed in 2006, and work on them got underway soon after. Despite difficult terrain, canals, and lakes, they had projected a 4-year time frame to complete this bridge. Total number of bridges in China are nearly 961,100, and increasing with the passage of time. In Hunan Province, central China, the Azai Bridge, which opened to traffic 10 years ago, has enhanced regional tourism and increased local peasants' incomes. The Azai Bridge, which spans the Dahang Canyon and is situated in Jishu City in Jiangxi, Tuizhou and Miao Autonomous Prefecture, was constructed as a section of the expressway connecting Changsha, the capital of Hunan, to southwest China's Chongqing Municipality. Xu Kiaozhang, one of the bridge's engineers who works for Hunan Road and Bridge Construction Group Company Limited, noted that the bridge has established several precedents in China's history of bridge construction, with a main span that is 1,176 meters long and built at an elevation of 355 meters above the valley floor. Su recounted that the bridge's construction workers overcame numerous difficulties, including difficult geographic conditions and a lack of resources over the course of 5 years beginning in October 2007. Local government officials and members of nearby villages of ethnic minority groups have investigated ways to combine the bridge's benefits for travel and tourism with focused efforts to reduce poverty. Infrastructures have significantly improved over time, and a large number of tourists are visiting. The Danyang Kunshan Grand Bridge, which connects Shanghai and Nanjing, is the longest bridge in the world, measuring 102.4 miles in length. It is a piece of the Beijing-Shanghai high-speed railway and is situated in the Chinese province of Jiangsu. This bridge was initially constructed to carry trains across an astounding distance on one of China's best high-speed railways. On June 30, 2011, the Danyang Kunshan Grand Bridge was inaugurated. The project cost $8.5 billion in total. With a staff of close to 10,000 people, the bridge's construction took 4 years to complete. It is resilient enough to resist direct hits from 300,000-ton Navy ships, as well as natural calamities like typhoons and earthquakes. In Jiangsu Province, Runyang Bridge is situated on the western border between Zhenjiang and Yangzhou. In the history of Chinese highway building, this massive bridge project features the most technically challenging suspension, cable stayed, and continuous pressurized concrete beam. It is the four vertical and four horizontal four roads primary framework and crosses the highway channel that runs beside the Yangtze River in Jiangsu Province, about 100 kilometers west of Nanjing and 300 kilometers east of Shanghai. China has unveiled the longest cross-ocean bridge in the world, demonstrating once more that its economy's strongest sectors are technology and economics. The Qingdao-Haiwan Bridge, which connects Qingdao City, which is situated in China's eastern Shandong province, with the Huangdao district, is nearly 26.4 miles long, according to the Telegraph. The Qingdao-Haiwan Bridge, which has incredible architectural significance and reduces the distance between the two locations by 30 kilometers, is a lifesaver in a country as busy as China, not to mention a popular tourist destination. The significant infrastructure project took 4 years to complete and cost $8.6 billion US dollars. The funds were used to purchase 450,000 tons of steel, which can survive an earthquake of magnitude 8. The recently completed amazing structure in the Zhaozhou River Delta is only expected to keep the record for a few years, since the authorities have already stated that they have begun construction on a new bridge that will connect the southern province of Guangdong with Hong Kong and Macau. The Precious Belt Bridge, also known as Bao Dai Bridge in Chinese, is situated northeast of Bao Dai Village in Wuzhong Economic Development Zone of Wuzhong District, west of the historic Beijing-Hangzhou Grand Canal. The State Council of China recognized it as a major site with respect to culture and history that is being protected at the national level in 2001. Now let's move towards the technology which is being used to construct these bridges. With the passage of time, new methods are being developed and they have revolutionized everything. Bridge building is undergoing a revolution as we enter a new century. Modern building techniques and the most cutting-edge materials are being developed. Developments in construction technology include post-tensioning, reinforced earth walls, and soil freezing. Utilizing optical and infrared technology, modern surveying techniques have made it easier to choose the soil and other design characteristics. Lighter and stronger decks are being produced thanks to advancements in deck technology. Since the introduction of cutting-edge testing facilities, bearings, joints, and seismic components have improved in performance. There will be an increase in reliable, affordable, quick, and planned inspection systems. The construction sector is currently being quickly impacted by, and they are transformed by, modern digital technologies. Modern technologies like use of artificial intelligence, drones, robots used for construction purposes, and other innovative advanced methods are now used to reduce time. Bridges are not an exception to the rule. Drones equipped with LiDAR sensors and GPS tracking are one of the smart construction technologies used in bridge design that are most frequently used. These drones allow bridge engineers to locate the precise spot where the bridge will be built, thus reducing mistakes. Providing effective supervisory management and structural health monitoring for bridges is now important to prepare for any unforeseen issues. With the development of technology, it is now possible to monitor everything that occurs on bridges. The supervisory control and data acquisition technology was implemented into Kuwait's Sheikh Jaber Al Ahmad Al Sabah Causeway as an example. Cameras are part of this system to monitor traffic flow in the event of an emergency. Furthermore, it enables total structural health monitoring of the bridge and combines condition monitoring, damage, or fracture identification in its concrete and steel structures. China is making efforts to become a superpower, and that's why they are developing new technologies to revolutionize the whole world. Complex building structures and bridges and a number of other things are on the way. We will keep you updated in our next videos. That's all for today's video. If you'd like to share your views, feel free to comment. Thanks.